little of the ways of the elements.
Instructor Fireheart, let's compare notes.
What to keep? Oh, why thank you. That was so nice of him.
Thank you so much.
I know when I've lost.
He's a green card player, don't question it, Ravenor. He wanted to be mana efficient and play the green card. We got the Fire Shaper! I have been on a constant quest for Fire Shapers. Now we need card draw pretty bad.
Sneaks into a magic school.
Are you retired, Dr. Stein?
On the loose.
like my invention.
Looks like an accident to me.
Glory, I'm here for the gold.
I did a decent amount of damage. Probably the Divide and Conquer for the Outcast cards. We really need to hit Khadgars though. Like, Goggles could be acceptable, but you really want the Khadgars.
Stelina versus Mozaki.
Spells be the greatest weapon of all.
Don't you mages get bored without any weapons?
I hope I get stargazing to show you guys all how terrible it is. Is that what my title says? That I'm the best Hearthstone streamer? Convince you that I'm the best Hearthstone streamer. Well, I'm consistent, I stream a lot, and I do not rage, which are very rare qualities in Hearthstone streamers. So I understand some people, there is a market for people who just want to watch people rage, but a lot of people just want to chill and have a good time. And that's what I try to provide. Jormeister99, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime. Glad you enjoy, thank you so much for the support.
I always
think I trade here. I think it would take more than a tier 3 sub for a private nude stream. I'm sorry, Smalls. But DM me on Discord if you would like to talk about pricing. I have absolutely no idea what it would cost, but I also acknowledge everyone has a price. So. Naked with leg behind. I actually can't do it that long with my leg behind my head. Circulation issues.
I serve the Fire Lord.
9 easy payments of $9,999. Still not quite there. Wait, I should play the spells.
I always come out on top.
Oh, so what makes this deck work is Fire Shaper. Without Fire Shaper, this deck doesn't work. Goggles, I guess, is an okay. What's the word? Outcast draw 2 death rattle minions, but I only have a 1 death rattle minion. Goggles is an okay constellation prize. Like, it's Goggles or Khadgar's, I would say.
Stalina versus Fireheart.
Do you know little of the ways of the elements, Instructor Fireheart? Let's compare notes. Never be afraid of your inner power.
Hello, Mike. Hope you're doing well. Oof.
They will never catch me.
I don't know what to do if he plays Cold Light here, or Cold Light Oracle. Cold Light Seer. It is Cold Light Seer. Man. Like, there's a Sigil of Silence, but, okay, Consume Magic, I guess, can help me, but I feel super screwed. Oh, that's lethal, right?
I see you've done your studies.
I don't know how I could have. The Sigil of Silence just wasn't positioned well, though, for Goggles. Good. Actually gonna take it. I think I want the Warblades.
Versus Lillian!
Go back to class. Leave me alone. sneaks into a magic school.
Someone didn't hit their passives. Okay. My deck is hit Fire Shaper or retire. His deck is lose and weep. I better not lose now after talking shit. But yeah, I mean, if we lose to a deck that isn't all together now and double battle cry, then I would say my complaining is for naught. But I'm confident that we see something that isn't meta that we should crush it. I should have attacked face first. That didn't happen, chat. No one saw a thing. I just want to point that out. You guys didn't see me miss 3 damage. I mean, if once you saw me start the turn, you could probably guess that that was going to happen. Jermeister, thank you for following. Blood and plunder. Very appreciated. Look at that silenced Dread Corsair. Not overloaded. Not overloaded. Our life total isn't anything to write home about. Yeah, if you mouse over their mana crystals here, it says if they're overloaded. Okay, Throwglaive would be a really cool card. What's really sad is Ilganoth would be one off lethal. Or no, I would be able to lethal with Ilganoth if I can hit his face. Don't tell me you got lethal. You still need one damage, sir. I don't think that's enough, chat. Two damage isn't gonna get it done. How many outs were there? One. And then I just have a ton of draw. So like two.
I'm short on time.
I would say about half my deck was lethal. The three missed damage! The three missed damage! Why did you have to remind me? Fully armored. Because of her. And her shrieking ghoul that came afterwards.
A spy sneaks into a magic school.
We lost to someone without perfect passives. And an imperfect deck because I misplayed. Thus, convincing the developers that the meta is fair and balanced. This all falls on my shoulders, chat.
like my invention.
How did he get the 10th Thrasher last game? I don't even remember.
To make a wish.
It no longer has charge chat.
The widow embraces me.
Still a lot of damage. 8 damage.
Care to make a wager, friend?
He's ignoring the worshipper, but that's 3 healing. Oh, he's killing it. Okay. Okay. I can get behind that a little bit.
They will never catch me.
I always come out on top.
Definitely have to kill him before turn 8.
What makes something real?
Please no taunts. Okay, no taunt. Please no taunt. Okay, no taunt. That might not have been optimally played. We also, our hand got heavy really quickly. There was a turn where I hero powered and maybe I shouldn't have. In there. Yeah, those were the days. Those were the 12-0 Demon Hunter days. Those were the days when if I put Demon Hunter up on YouTube, it would... It could be like a 12-0 in 30 minutes and no one would watch it. Because everyone was sick of Demon Hunter.
Leave me alone. What kind of spy sneaks into a magic school?
Most of, like, oh my god, I posted so many double time decks to the YouTube. Like, all of my druid runs were double time, and people were like... People, like, stopped being excited at all. It was just like, well... A druid run that's more than 30 minutes, guess we hit double time. It is better than Robes of Gaudiness meta. Is it? Probably. But like... Robes of Gaudiness couldn't hit you till game 5. Whereas, all together now, Double Battle Cry starts hitting you game 4. Or, the Robes of Gaudiness couldn't hit you till game 6.
Glory. I'm here for the gold.
This Lake Thresher is really being a pain in the butt. But yeah, it's better than the Robes meta. What was awful about the Robes meta was when they announced that Robes was no longer available to pick, and then it was still pickable for like 5 days. And then it took a few weeks to get rid of them all. So what robes used to do is made it so that cards costed half price, rounded down, which was the most absurd part. So 5 mana cards costed 2, but you could only play 2 cards a turn. But the rounded down part was the shit that was not okay. It made something busted just... Yeah, like the 7 mana for 3. It was just breaking everything. Like, Wish cost 11 mana at the time, and it was playable for 5. I got that combo my very first run. Sadly, I didn't play great and it didn't go 12, but... Yeah, it was 11 mana. Yeah, I mean, I don't think we're getting the, Come on. Okay. I would be pretty annoyed if I were him. Hey, no, no, no. You're not allowed to at him here. You can add him on Twitter. 10-minute timeout, aerator. No adding devs in the chat. He comes here to enjoy himself. That is not okay. Only I'm allowed to harass him. In this stream. I don't know exactly what the breakdown is at Team 5, but it seems that Tav is the one that is the most knowledgeable about duels. And at least the most public one with knowledge, but...
Let's see if you're as good as your grades are.
Go easy on me, Lady Barov. I'm your top student.
I actually didn't even read what you read, but, But yeah, like if you want to send him information, just send it on Twitter to him or something. Which chat is for fun. I actually thought about blacklisting his name. I did actually think about that conceit. Because if I blacklist his name, then whenever something annoying happens, everyone could add him and just get purged instead, and it would just be like a black chat. I thought that might be fun. I hate using my healing so early. That lethal? Yeah. We did it! I might get to 7 wins. We would be at 7 wins if it wasn't for that misplay. I don't think you get notifications when you get added, but maybe. I do think these Warblades are really good, especially for one man. I mean, I enjoyed playing Outcast back in the day, I guess.
Hi, Professor Turalian.
And keep that, maybe. But, yeah, I don't know. It's hard to describe. I've made my opinions pretty well known about this meta. Disc of Legends, it's most likely pretty hard to break through. Well, I assume that the patch with the mini set will have some change, but I don't think it's the change that necessarily I want. So, but a change will happen. I don't know what it'll be or how minor it will be. DJ, thanks for following. And that's just what I believe will happen. But we're still due for that update that they promised way back at BlizzCon.
I always come out on top.
Where I expect us to get all the mercenary heroes in duels. Yeah. So. And I assume that that's not coming with the mini set. Maybe they're waiting. Man, I don't want that to come out with mercenaries, because no one's going to be playing duels then. Hopefully at least we get the Mercenary Heroes a week before Mercenaries comes out or something. Because, like, ah. I have no idea. I think it'll be, how it was explained at BlizzCon was that we were going to be getting 10 new heroes, and that they would, add to the collection. Or, like, we would still have heroes. Like, you would still have hero powers and stuff that you unlocked with the old heroes. So I assume that it would be, like, 20 heroes in. I mean, there's a chance that that's coming. But I feel like they would have announced it today. So, like, their goal is to constantly have content coming out with updates and stuff. So, like, it was Battlegrounds, and now here's a standard update, and then the duels update, then Mercenaries is... But, yeah. And again, this is just my reading of the tea leaves. I don't get insider information. But I think I read it relatively well. So it's never going to be lethal, so I just do this. I was worried about Reckoning. Like, we're locked into getting dual support through the end of the year. I don't know what the plans are after that point. I mean, they could change their mind, but currently the plans are for dual support through the end of the year. There is a duels update scheduled for each expansion on the pipeline thing. So. But yeah, and hopefully there will be some changes so that we can, because, like, new heroes won't make a difference if the passives are what's dominating everything. Oh, he needed that to kill the taunt. So much more than most. Like, the game isn't built to be played 8 hours a day. So. But in my defense, I'm capable of playing stuff longer than most. Yeah, like, you could do, like, 20 damage turn one. So I see this thing on Twitter about cicadas. Does anyone else hate cicadas? Like, I, not that I hate them, but I think they're the most disgusting thing ever. And terrifying. You've never seen, like, a housefly that's, like, 3 inches long? Lucky you. Yeah, they're also really loud. They sound like crickets on steroids. And so, like, you hear it and you assume that, like, you're surrounded by, like, 50 of them. And it's actually just one sometimes. Oh, I should have played that to maybe push the damage phase. Well, I'll just do it now. That's my bad. I don't know. I feel like that's a pretty apt description. A fly that's like 3 inches long. And terrifying. Oh my god. I hate them so much. I bet there was a lethal there. I should have killed this one to taunt him. Il'Gynoth would trigger first. So if I attacked the Deathrattle, he would have died. He would have gained the armor, but then he would have exploded.
Stalina versus Slate.
And maybe we'll go Easter egg hunting with Dragon Shaman.
Are you trying to stain my perfect record?
You're accusing me of not playing for fun? Have you not seen how much spell druid I've played. Do I play the sigil turn one, chat? Yeah, I think I play it turn one. Okay, well, for sure now. The only deck that I've seen everyone love is Charge Priest. The true meta breaker. I have to say, the Charge Priest games that Tice played were... I just thought that they were the funniest things I ever watched.
Grand Widow. Grand Widow.
I always come out on top.
I think it's oh, it's not open to cages. We're burning a card! It's okay, we didn't want to play Double Jump anyway, because all it does is make it so we won't have six cards in our deck to draw. Hey, congrats, Rafam. I don't even have the 12-0 Warrior achievement. But I blame Stream Snipers whenever I don't get 12-0, so it's fine. I think I only have 5 12-0s. Yeah, one of them got ruined by a Stream Sniper, and then he got banned.
My eyes for vengeance.
I always come out on top.
I have a 12-0 with Shaman. It was the rally, the broken meta. I got 12-0 with Shaman.
Make true toys of them.
Wait, do I overdraw doing this? Yes.
I always come out on top.
Fear my blade.
I'll send you a screenshot of a 0-3 in the next few days. I mean, there are enough Battlecry shop. Like, you could make Dragon Shaman work, probably. What do we do? So the issue with Necrotic Poison is your opponent has to... If your opponent doesn't play a minion... I guess I could... I have enough minions that I can kill my own minions.
Stellina versus Fireheart.
You know little of the ways of the elements. Instructor Fireheart, let's compare notes.
Come on! I knew I should have kept the one mana card. I should have just kept the one mana card. I knew it. I knew it, chat.
Got a job for me?
No, getting second sword isn't good at all. It's actually actively terrible.
Catch me.
Oh yeah, Rafam, we've known that for a while. That was actually the only way for some people to play for a short period of time. Because when Core came out, you couldn't use Core cards. So, the workaround was to... Or you couldn't use Golden Core cards.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, it's more damage and we're at 40. No, there's no way to guarantee goggles. I think if you have a lot of cheap cards, it considers that synergy, like cards that cost 3 or less. I have literally no idea. I have no idea how to control goggles. I don't know. So, what I think is happening is... it's seeing goggles as a synergistic pick, and then it's also giving you goggles as a random pick. Is what I believe is happening. Looks like Blizzard flipped this RNG switch. To change what deck I play. This is actually, like, worst case in... Man, you think I would have learned my lesson last game? A problem. I should have hero powered, maybe. I don't know. Whatever. Everything will get fixed. I just need that to get no buffs. I said no buffs. I said no buffs! I'm pretty sure I said no buffs, chat. We do have consume magic, but we're at 3 health unless we die here. So that's nice.
Well done.
If you hit the 2 divine, this is also considered a strong deck. It's very strong. but getting Avenging Armaments is... I failed 3 times when hard forcing it, so... But if you're watching on YouTube, please be sure you like, subscribe, comment. Join the Discord if you're interested in decklists. And... Although I don't think this one is posted. And watch me every day on twitch.tv/TeamAmerica. And always, as always, thanks for watching.